Leonardo da Vinci's hand-drawn illustrations of various polyhedra in the Divina Proportione of 1509 is depicting wooden models that were constructed by Luca Pacioli. Da Vinci briefly studied geometry with Pacioli, but focused on considerations of shape, size, and perspective, on descriptive features of objects rather than their theoretical foundations. He was a painter, a sculptor, a writer, an engineer, an inventor, a scientist, a botanist, an anatomist, a poet, and a skilled musician. Leonardo was an all-rounder and a forward thinker who is inspiring and even surprising us up to this day. Leonardo da Vinci, man. Okay, let's look at the Vitruvian Man Project, for example. It is exhibiting not only Leonardo's intimate knowledge and perfect understanding of the structure and its geometry, but it is also disclosing to us yet undiscovered hidden chambers inside of the Great Pyramid of Giza, of which one has been confirmed already. We know now that the Vitruvian Man drawing contains hidden information that Leonardo himself has incorporated. And I believe that this is showing us how and in which way Leonardo da Vinci was ahead of his time. Dude was the embodiment of interdisciplinary learning and thinking. And his drawings of the regular polyhedra of the wooden models created by Luca Pacioli, they're very evident of that. They're very representative of that. To me, they are. You know, at least to me, they are. He's done it again. To me, he's done it again. Bringing everything back around full circle, back to the squaring of the circle, back to Egypt, and back to the Great Pyramid of Giza. Which brings us in the now to Egyptian architect and scientist Dr. Ibrahim Karim, who founded after more than 30 years of his research, biogeometry. Dr. Karim's breakthrough research identified a unique energy effect found in the energetic centers of all living systems. This BG-free energy quality is responsible for maintaining the energy structures of all living systems, including the balance of the different energy qualities involved. Biogeometry uses proprietary shapes which interact with the peripheral energy fields of the body to amplify the presence of this highly beneficial BG-free energy quality, as well as to harmonize energy interactions with the environment. You know, research-based thinking and learning. Right there is the research, we got the science, everything is right there. We got it all laid out, proven on the lab bench. Have the physics of sound, of frequency, of waves been crippled, even suppressed? And at the same time, have they been weaponized? Did the walls of Jericho fall through sound? Was the universe created by the word, by sound, by a tone, by a wave? Dr. Karim also refers to biogeometry as the science of the shape-caused wave, also known as compression or sound waves, even though we cannot hear them. But Dr. Ibrahim Karim is by far not the only one. Dan Winter's research is telling us the same story from a different perspective. In the optics department of physics, for example, we encounter the pump phase conjugate mirror. Dan Winter is showing us how pump phase conjugation, wave-fractality, converts the vertical transverse EMF wave into a longitudinal scalar wave. His work with the golden ratio is also very scientific, documenting the centripetal charge field that you get when working with the golden ratio. The shape of things plays a greater role than assumed. Over 2000 years ago, the ancient Greeks exercised thought experiments concerning what we and everything around us is constructed of. And eventually, we came up with the periodic table. Now we know that everything is actually wave and particle, but that the particle flux is determined by the coherent order, by the quantum field, which causes particles to flow, to vibrate, and to oscillate in certain ways, tessellating according to the vibrational marker. And I'm like, the ancient Greeks weren't that far off at all with their theory of everything being made up of platonic solids, except that these shapes aren't solid at all, but rather coherent orders, quantum fields that determine the flow of the virtual particle flux river, the virtual particle flux field in the vacuum. as the Royal Institute is officially admitting now.
In fact, the very best theories we have of physics don't rely on particles at all. The best theories we have tell us that the fundamental building blocks of nature are not particles, but something much more nebulous and abstract. The fundamental building blocks of nature are fluid-like substances which are spread throughout the entire universe and ripple in strange and interesting ways. Okay? That's the fundamental reality in which we live. These fluid-like substances, we have a name for, we call them fields.
And so, it is clear to me, thanks to people like retired Lieutenant Colonel Thomas Bearden, like Dan Winter, like Nikola Tesla, and like T. Townsend Brown, that we understand now that physical reality is absolutely engineerable, that we can control the virtual quantum flux field in a vacuum engine. And what order out of chaos really means.
In chaos theory, if you have hidden order and you start to collect it, that is amplify it more and more, you reach a region where suddenly the order grows. And you seal that position one, you suddenly have a recognizable order.
We understand now how each and every order is happening at an incredible speed in the vacuum of space, and that it is the density of something that determines if it becomes a 3D reality. And that is a major step up from fused deposit modeling, if you ask me. Because essentially, we are speaking here now of materialization, even of teleportation. Is that far-fetched? Not if we look at the work of Daryl Anka, his brilliant work that helps us comprehend these apparently difficult and complex workings of advanced physics.
While you think of an object as existing in a location, to us, location is one of the properties of the object. If you thus then have an object at point A, and you are able to isolate it with an energy bubble, in a sense, unlock it from any particular reality, and thus then impose upon it the vibrational signature frequency of location B, it must stop existing at location A and instantaneously start taking up residence at location B without actually having traveled the intervening distance.
The virtual particle flux field, vacuum engines, tetrahedral, octahedral, dodecahedral, and icosahedral quantum fields. It seems the Vedas knew all of this all along. Why our understanding of the past just might hold the key to our future, as it is written in the Valley of Wonderment. Dost thou reckon thyself only a puny form, when within thee the universe is folded? Reflecting on this statement and looking at the nesting relationship between icosahedron, which is representative of the human, and the dodecahedron, which is representative of the universe, according to the Pythagorean cosmic morphology, one could argue which one resides within the other. In other words, one could ask in a different way which one came first, the chicken or the egg. If it is the icosahedron nesting within the dodecahedron, or vice versa, or better yet, and vice versa, however it may be, it is now on us and the coming generations to pick up on these Tesla and Faraday technologies and on the works of Whitaker, Maxwell, Bearden, and Karim, and to bring about the new sciences of which John E. Fetzer spoke when he said, "I feel that we are on a threshold of a new order where people will be seeking enlightened change. This will all come about with the infusion of spirituality into science."